Hi guys, welcome back to the Mushroom Market. So I'm here today to show you guys some packs that I have made up that are going to go into my Etsy shop. I've been working on these for the past couple of weeks, just here and there, and I have made 20 packs. And yeah, we'll go through them all and we'll see what's inside. So they're a complete mixture of vintage goods. Over the past, maybe a couple of months, I have been visiting antique stores and sort of just, I've been shopping on eBay and things like that, and I've been accumulating some really, really nice vintage things. So that's where these packs all come from. So yeah, like I said, there's 20 packs that are going to be available. Now, I believe there is over 50 pieces. I'm thinking 53, 54 pieces in each pack. I'll put all the specific details in the listing for you guys. But this is how the packs come. So they come, of course, packaged in this clear bag here. I usually do this with my items because I kind of have this thing where I always think, well, I've had it happen to me. So sometimes if it's raining in other parts of the world and your mail gets chucked in the mailbox, it can get soaked through. So that's why I tend to wrap everything in plastic, because then I know it's going to protect it from some water damage and things like that as well. So yeah, just a little bit of info there for you guys. So yeah, each and every pack is pretty much the same. Of course, there are going to be some subtle sort of differences here and there, such as the different photographs, the different cigarette cards, different postcards, but they're all the same types of things. So yeah, each one will be different, but and they've all got these beautiful little floral buttons, and I've just wrapped them in twine, so they look like that. And yeah, each button's a different color. So that one's a red color. I think there's green and pink. So they're all ready to go. And they'll get sent out at random, but I will pop all these aside now and we'll go through a pack that I have left unopened so that we could go through the contents. Sorry guys, let me just pop all these off. I had such a great time making these up as well. As you guys know, I really love to do that because I just love sharing with the things that I can find in my part of the world. So here's a pack that we've got. I'll just zoom you guys in a little bit. So this is a pack that is undecorated, it's unsealed, just so I can pull everything out. And these are similar to the last vintage packs that I had, except that everything in them is different to the last packs, but it's the same idea. So I'll just pop that aside. So what I've got here, I'll try and see where to start. I've got this beautiful playing card. It's from the 1950s. Let me just show you guys. I got it from the antique store that I made a video on. So that's what they look like. Very vintage. Everything in these packs is really vintage. There's only one item in here that is the earliest that it's from is 1990, which is 20 years old now. But that's the earliest thing that I have. The rest of the stuff is much earlier than that. So this one here, this lovely playing card is, look how patina it is. It's from the 1950s. It's got this lovely lady with this hat and dog. It's so sweet. And then each pack comes with a black and white postcard. The postcards are from different places. This one's from Bournemouth. There are also postcards that are from Brighton, which I actually picked up from Brighton in my travels. That's another thing. A lot of these packs that I have here, they tell a story. I've got different bits and pieces that I've collected, not only from my region, but from different parts of the world when I've been traveling as well. So some of the postcards are from Brighton, from my trip to Brighton, but this one here is from Bournemouth, sorry. And this postcard came from an antique store down in New South Wales when I was traveling down there. So then you get three black and white vintage photographs. Each photograph is different, might be a different size and style and that kind of thing. This one here's got this sweet little girl. And this, I think she looks like a teenager. A lot of these photos that I did get are from foreign countries. So some of them may come with writing on the back in a different language. Not too sure where this one is from, but it is from overseas. And then this one here, from 1961, I think. So there's that one. And then we've got two vintage slides. Now, I got these from sort of a consignment shop that had a lot of vintage goods in it as well. So they came in packs like these little boxes. And they're from Hong Kong. Not sure the exact date on the slides, but yeah, vintage nonetheless. And this one here says, oh, it doesn't say anything, but some of them do have writing that says, but this is of a beautiful, beautiful house. Yeah, I don't know if you can see. And then this one is of Hong Kong Harbour. So you get two of those vintage slides. Then you will get a couple of these cards. Now these are shell cards. I will show you the book that they came out of, that I picked up from a vintage bookstore. They came out of an album that is a shell project card album, Butterflies and Moths. And I've taken them all out of this album. So you may get a butterfly or a moth or two butterflies or two moths there. So there's that. And on the back they've got like writing on them. And then this third one here is a bird. And I got this from an antique store. So the third one that you might get might be a bird or a butterfly, or it might be like a landscape. But they're all vintage cards. Then there is this vintage postcard, and this is in Switzerland. So it's a tiny little miniature postcard. It's so cute. And each one will have different scenes on it. Then there is a vintage invitation card. There are three different types that come in these packs. So there is this one here, which has got this beautiful poppies, and it's got date, time, place. And then there's another one which is like a floral vintage, another floral vintage invitation card. I'm just trying to see if I can find one that sort of shows it for you guys. But I don't think I do. And then the third one is a vintage cat. And yeah, I don't think I can see it here. If you can see the little vintage cat there. And it's so sweet. So there are three different types of cards. There's the cat again. That you'll get in these packs. But this one's just got this green one. It's a Hallmark card. And then we've got some vintage tickets. I think these are the bus tickets or tram tickets. Now there are six of them in these packs, and three of them are like a black color and three are a brown color. So yeah, six of those. Then there is another couple of vintage playing cards of these beautiful floral designs, or these roses actually. And they are just so beautiful. Each card is different here, so well, this set, sorry, it's different. So you've got this picture here and this picture here. So then we've got two score sheets, and these tell a story as well. I did get these from an antique store in Leiden, which is in the Netherlands, a beautiful sort of university town in the Netherlands that I stayed in for 2 weeks. And yeah, it's in Dutch, so it's just, they're a lot of fun. And then these ones here are really vintage bridge scorers as well, which I got from an antique store. Then there are three stamps, so a butterfly one and two floral ones from New Zealand. So 4D, 2.5 cents and 4 cents. So they're old ones. And then we've got a couple of Russian desktop calendar sheets. I bought this from eBay, and yeah, there's one is in red and one is in black, and they're just desktop sheets, and they've got this beautiful Russian writing. I think I'd mentioned to you guys before. I just absolutely adore Russian writing. I just think it's really, really beautiful font. And then on the back, it's got some more just Russian writing on the back. So a couple of sheets of those. Then we've got a vintage floral, what do you call these? It's kind of like a, well, it's come from the Australian Women's Weekly Greenhouse. So they're just cards, and they've got the picture and then just sort of a description on the back. So each one of these will have a different flower on it. I've got this vintage lottery ticket. These will either come in pink or green, and they're from the 1960s. Some will have writing on them, or some will be completely blank, like this one. So 1966. This is the newest edition in this pack from 1990. This is from Singapore, and these are some vintage flashcards. So they'll either come double-sided like that. I think one's got some children's images on the back. But yeah, really, really vintage. You can see all the vintage marks on it. That's the other thing. A lot of this stuff does have, you know, vintage patina and things like that to the items. So I've got this beautiful butterfly card. Now, these are just gorgeous. I think I've shown you guys. I picked these up at a store as Butterflies and Moss Edu Cards of Nature. And so just beautiful. They were 54 full color photo cards, and then you've got a description on the back. So each one is different. It'll either be a butterfly or a moth, and they're just beautiful. So they're from, I think they did have the date somewhere. No, but I think it 1961. There you go, there's the date. And then we've got two vintage envelopes. I also won these in an auction, and they're empty, so there's nothing on the inside, but they're from the 1940s, and each envelope is different. So, you know, you might get, see, that's got a marks and stuff that just shows the age, patina. There might be ripping and things like that on them. But that's just what comes with envelopes. But these are a lot of fun to include in your journals and things like that, or you can cut them at the top there and stitch and make a pocket and add things to them. And I do believe that these were being sold not for the envelopes but for the stamps, so I think that these are sort of collector's stamps, just from what I read in the description of the item when it was up for auction. So something about these stamps that are collectible on here. So yeah, I think it's got Prince, I don't know his name, but yeah, anyway, so there's two of those. You've got an email envelope as well, and then you will get a piece of vintage ephemera. Now, each pack has a completely different piece of ephemera. Some just they range from the dates. There might be checks, there might be bank statements, or all sorts of pieces of vintage ephemera. This one here just happens to be it's a war package, so a food package. So yeah, from October 1944, American National Red Cross, receipt for prisoner of war package. So it says, I have received one food package from the American National Red Cross through the International Committee of the Red Cross. So yeah, that's really, really interesting. So I think about five packs come with those, and then the rest are completely different. Then you'll get a couple of sheets of this very old school ledger. I think I've shown you guys these before. So the dates range from around about 1899 to 1902. They came like this, so I've pulled some sheets out to pop in these packs. And yeah, the same sort of deal, because they're old, they might have some marks and things on them, but that's just what comes with being vintage, you know. So some might have more writing, some might have less, but just stunning pieces of history there. And then we get into like our book pages and things like that. So I have shared with you guys my very favourite mushroom book, the one that I had when I chose the name of my shop, The Mushroom Market. So I decided to finally use that one, and yeah, you'll get a sheet of these mushrooms. Each one will have different types of mushrooms or fungi and things like that on them, so that's what this one is, and you can fussy cut those out or use the page as is. Then there is this beautiful plant page. Each one is different as well, and it was it came from, let me just grab it, this beautiful book here, which is Indoor Plants, the Pocket Encyclopedia of Indoor Plants. It has some really lovely pictures in it, and I'm not too sure the date, but it's very vintage, 1970, so that's where that one's come from. And then this is trying to think, it was from some books that I bought quite some time ago, Common Birds of New Zealand. So it came like this, and I've taken some sheets out for you guys, so you'll each get a different one of those. Then there is this vintage sort of table book, and I believe that it's a sort of a hardware book, but I pulled the pages out that had these interesting tables on it, just because I love tables, sort of things like that as well. So yeah, timber, groups, it's got numbers and things like that. So an interesting piece of paper there. Now this one here is extremely old. It's from the very early 1900s, and it's from a children's book called Little Folks. And I had been hoarding this book for the longest time. But it was completely falling apart because it was so old. So I decided to pull some pages out, and each page will be different, but yeah, it's just so old, and so many beautiful vintage markings on it. So yeah, very, very interesting book page there. This one here is a vintage atlas book, and this also has a story behind it. I did get this from the book fest a couple of years ago now, but what was interesting about this travel book was that it was from, I think, this around about the 60s or the 70s, and it was obviously very well used and loved, and I think it was a couple who had travelled through Europe, and they had left a lot of their travel ephemera all throughout this this really big sort of travel atlas book. It had maps in it, but then it also had things like hotels and lots of information in it, so it was very, very interesting. And you can see they've underlined different places here. Some pieces of paper will have writing on them, you know, little bits of writing, some may not, but yeah, it completely tells a story of this couple's journey, really, and I think that was really, really fascinating. So you get a sheet of that. Then there is a sheet of this shorthand book page, which is so interesting. I really, really love the look of that. There's a piece of ledger paper, so you can pop that in your journals. A piece of my absolute favourite vintage lined paper. I just adore using that. I actually used it in my Christmas journal that I just made. Then you'll get a piece of vintage graph paper. You'll either get one that's this purple and red one, or green. Now this graph paper is actually Dutch, so I think I can show you guys, because when I brought the packs, they were in a different language, like they look like this. I'm not actually too sure, but it's definitely not English, so I don't know where they've come from, but very, very interesting nonetheless. And then you'll get a piece of this, it's a book that was called Stamps of the World, and it's from 1977, and it's quite a large sheet, so I've had to fold it. But yeah, really interesting. You can actually cut these little pictures of stamps out and use them on ephemera, which I've done before. It's double-sided, and yeah, really patinaed around the edges. And then this lovely vintage piece of French book page. And then last but not least is a piece of my new wallpaper. So in the last packs I put in some other pieces of wallpaper, but with these ones I didn't want to have the same stuff as in my last packs, so I just included a piece of my new wallpaper, which is this beautiful blue and green and sort of brown floral pattern. So that is it, you guys. I hope you enjoyed looking through these little packs, and they are going to be up for sale as soon as this video is up on YouTube. I will be popping all the links to my shop down below, and yeah, they're all packaged and ready to go, so I should be able to ship them out quite quickly. This video will probably go up either Friday night or Saturday, and I will be shipping them no later than Tuesday. So yeah, that's it, you guys. I hope you enjoyed watching, and I will be back soon because I am working in my December album and I want to share it with you guys. But I hope you guys all have a lovely weekend, and I'll chat to you in my next video. Bye, guys!